Whatever, 133 million anyway, so it's not like I'm going to struggle to pay my fuel prices. Okay. Let's get it in a decent gear, otherwise... Okay, we've got 183 miles to go, and I know... I know this truck can hold 2,000... No, it's 1,100 litres, yeah. 1,135 litres it had just there. Because I'm hoping with American Truck Simulator that we're going to get a lot more, like the older trucks, the old American trucks, because it'd be nice to see like a, 1960s Mack from the movie Convoy. Be really cool to see if somebody will create that with the fuel tanker or chemicals that he was carrying in the movie. Because I'm really surprised no one's done it for this, but I can only hope. So if anybody's watching and they're really good at making trucks or know how to convert them or whatever, I'd like to see a Mack truck from Convoy, a rubber duck. Because I read in the posts a few weeks back that they're willing to keep updating ETS2, and then obviously American Truck will be updated with DLC, etc. But the multiplayer would be the best thing. Even if it's dedicated servers, that'd be great, but to be able to host the game and have your friend join up and drive, I'm not worried about speeding, and join up and just drive around in the same world that you're in, that would be great. Because I know that the multiplayer mod that's available isn't that great, but it would be nice to see it. I know that they did say that multiplayer is on their to-do list, and I imagine they will get round to it. Because I think ETS2. Has got not much to update, but they could do with putting the rest of France in and Italy. They definitely need to put that in, because that's missing. I know the UK isn't as complete as it could be. I know Pro Mods has got a lot more going on there, and everywhere else, to be honest. Ireland might be interesting. I know my friend Buffer Kid that I normally talk to about this game, he's would like to see Ireland, but not entirely sure whether it'd be worth it, because I know Ireland is sort of like a lot of country sort of roads which might not sort of lead anywhere. So I could be wrong, but yeah, just might be a bit too much work for them to take on. There's plenty of mods that add Russia and stuff like that, so SCS don't need to do that. Not when the modding community is sort of doing it for them. But they do need to finish France and Italy and add more into like Germany and Sweden. Maybe add like the top of Sweden and all that in there, because that would be good to see. And then as for American Truck Simulator, the more they add in, the better. And obviously that will add all the states that are sort of relevant, I'd imagine. Because to drive across the country would be sort of really cool. And then if they add like Canada in and put some of the like dangerous areas in, the ice roads, that again would be insane. Because I do like to play 18 Wheels of Steel Extreme Trucker 2, which has got the not entirely sure what part of the world it's supposed to be, but they have the ice roads there with like hazards and accidents and all sorts of things going on. You have to watch out for, and if you go too fast, that you can break through the ice and stuff like that. It's a fairly old game now, but it's interesting to check out if you haven't played that before. There's a few other destinations there. There's like Indonesia, Australia. There's like a, I can't think where there's like a wooded sort of area. I can't remember where that is, but that's quite fun to drive, where you've got like sort of valleys and sort of hills, and you've got gaps in the road which are sort of filled with logs that you have to drive over. So $65 to go. Okay, so hopefully this isn't going to take too long. I might have to break this up into a couple of parts, because I don't like using the fatigue simulator. Okay, here's a prime example. See the road where you can only go right. See, there's no barrier stopping you from there's no barrier there to stop you from driving down there. So I can actually drive down there. The likelihood is that I'll get to a point where I won't be able to go any further and I have to turn around, or I'll just fall through the map, which isn't the best thing. That corner a little bit too wide, but doesn't matter. I am overdriving the truck a little bit, over going too high in the revs, but it's the only way you can get this truck to accelerate. You want it to pull to get up to speed, and you need to drive it fairly hard. Looks like we've got some snow. Yeah, another interesting sort of concept maybe is to have voice chat in the American Truck Simulator. So you can, like for the multiplayer, you could then, you know, use it like a CB radio, communications type. I know a lot of people would definitely love that, to be able to talk in like CB sort of slang, sort of breaker 19 and all that sort of stuff, and use all the codes that they use, etc. I don't need my high beams, it's okay. Yeah, because that'd be quite fun in general, really, just to talk slang with people. Especially if you add the static cue after every time you talk, it might get annoying, but it would be funny though. Like every time you talk, you at the end of it. There's always one. Can't risk it on the bend. Okay, now though. Surely that I did not see what truck it was. I think it was a Volvo or a MAN, but still should be capable of pulling its load up that hill there. I'm not gonna give way. I give way, then there'll be 20 vehicles coming along. I have to put up with that and be stuck behind it. So it looks like we're at our destination. Now you get ready for some excellent parking skills. Well, hopefully that is. He looked like he was going to drive towards me. That name is Volvo. Yeah, still got the Christmas lights going. Which is a little bit. It's like the 10th of January, so it's, yeah, a bit late for that now, but. But this is one thing I do like about this mod, is that instead of having the box with the arrow pointing down into it, you just get cones. Be easy if there was like a more simplistic marker, but I don't know what else you could actually use. just going to get it to drive around now. Might have to readjust that. Yeah. Plenty of room. One thing with this Peterbilt, it doesn't like to push the trailers down. It will do its most difficult to actually push the trailer in the direction that you want it to. Telling that tiny little mirror that we're almost there. There we go. We got it. And not a bad parking job. We did alright. So, there we go. I'll drop that off. Which strange that's reflected. What's it reflecting? Ah, that. Okay. Yeah, so I'll drop that trail off and call it a day. I hope you've enjoyed the videos, because I guess this will be a two-part, or probably will have been a two-part. Keep a lookout for new content. Should be soon. Thanks for watching.